This is CNN Breaking News.
Breaking news, will Donald Trump's children be granted top security clearance when he becomes president? This is CNN Tonight. I'm Don Lemon. At the same time, sources telling CNN about severe infighting within Trump's transition team. One source calling it a knife fight, while meanwhile President Barack Obama urging Americans to give the president-elect a chance.
I don't think he is ideological. I think ultimately he's pragmatic in that way. That can serve him well, as long as he's got good people around him and he has a clear sense of direction.
I want to begin this hour with CNN White House correspondent Athena Jones. Athena, good evening to you. You were at the president's press conference today, the first since Donald Trump won the election. What's your takeaway?
I thought it was interesting, Don, how much time the president spent talking about what he views as some of his administration's biggest achievements. He spent almost as much time reminding viewers about those accomplishments as he did trying to, it seemed like, ease the concerns of people who did not support Donald Trump. And that clip you just played, I thought, was also an interesting takeaway. The president spoke quite a bit about that meeting he had with President-elect Trump last week in the Oval Office. They sat down and talked for an hour and a half. And his takeaway was that Trump, as you played, is not ideological. That he's pragmatic in a way that could serve him well if he has good people around him and a clear sense of direction. Well, today I asked President Obama about one of the people that Trump has around him, a person he has tapped to be a chief strategist and a senior advisor in his White House, and that is Steve Bannon, the former head of Breitbart News. As you know, it's a website that has championed white nationalist themes. And so I asked the president, what message does it send to the country and to the world, having a person like Steve Bannon having such a prominent role in your White House? The president didn't want to comment. He said it would be inappropriate for him to comment in the interest of trying to facilitate a smooth transition. He went on to say that the voters have spoken. Donald Trump will be the 45th president. And here's some more of what he had to say.
Those who didn't vote for him have to recognize that that's how democracy works. That's how this system operates. When I won, there were a number of people who didn't like me and didn't like what I stood for. And, I think that whenever you've got an incoming president of the other side, particularly in a bitter election like this, it takes a while for people to reconcile themselves with that new reality. Hopefully it's a reminder that elections matter and voting counts. And so, I don't know how many times we have to relearn this lesson, because we ended up having 43% of the country not voting who were eligible to vote, but it makes a difference.
So elections matter. That's a message the sort of theme he repeated more than once. And so, Don, we saw a very different tone from the president today in this press conference than we've seen over the last several weeks or longer, of him being on the campaign trail, throwing barbs at Donald Trump, and sometimes speaking in apocalyptic terms about a Trump presidency. Today he was calm. He spoke carefully. He was measured. And at times it almost seemed like he was trying to send a message about how a president should speak, how a president should carry himself. So yeah, it was a very, very interesting press conference.
How a president should conduct himself. Yeah, thank you very much. I appreciate that, Athena. I want to bring in now Washington Post.